My name is Keith Headley. I served in the United States Navy 1966 through 69 on a couple of ships. What I'm going to talk about now is the USS James E. Keyes, when a very tragic accident happened, not to the James Keyes, but to one of the ships we were traveling with, the USS Frank Evans. We were doing a multi-nation anti-submarine warfare exercise, and we were operating with the Australian aircraft carrier HMAS Milburn, and we were operating in the South China Sea at 3 a.m. on the morning of June 3rd, 1969. I had been sleeping. I had come off watch in Combat Information Center at midnight, and I heard the microphone click for the 1MC announcing system. You can hear the microphone being almost like somebody was fighting over the darn thing. It was fumbling around, and I can hear this voice saying, "Give me that!" And it was the captain. I could recognize his voice. And he, when he got the microphone fully under his control, he basically made a rather startling announcement. "This is the captain. There has been a collision between the Evans and the Milburn. Get your butts out of your racks, man the rails, and look for survivors in the water." And that woke us all up, you know, pretty quickly. After about 15 minutes of looking, I grabbed a pair of binoculars that were nearby. A helicopter flew over, and they had their searchlight pointed straight down. And when they illuminated the fantail of the stern of the ship, I could see it was the Evans. You could see the Frank Evans name on the stern of the ship. And then all of a sudden, there was nothing. It went from the smokestack to the flat area between the two stacks, and then there was just absolutely no more ship left. And it was quite shocking. You know, up until this point, we were just thinking, collision, bumped into each other, people got knocked off the ship. Now we know we had a situation where at least half the ship is now gone, presumably sunk. So this has gotten a whole lot more serious. So here we have the ASW screen layout for that night. The Milburn would be in the middle here. My ship, the James Keyes, almost directly ahead. The Evans on the left-hand quarter of where the Milburn is. And then we had a couple of other destroyers from our squadron that were also involved. And sadly, when the accident was over, we had 74 American sailors' lives are lost, and only one body was recovered. So what happens first is the Milburn radios to everybody, okay, we're going to flight operations. Problem is, the course change was done in code. It's wartime exercises. So we all had to decode that to find out what's going on. The problem is, the Evans, when they decoded the course, they did it wrong. The Evans thought that the Milburn was going in almost the opposite direction. So, when the Evans turned right into the path of the Milburn. And in these tight formations, you know, they're only about 3,000, 4,000 yards apart, which sounds like a lot, but it's not. So the Milburn radios the Evans, not once, not twice, but three times, we're on a collision course. And the Evans acknowledged it, but didn't do anything. So the Milburn said again, "Hey, we're on a collision course, but we're getting so close now." The Milburn said, "I'm coming port," which was the right thing to do at that moment. It would put her safely astern of the Evans, and the worst thing could happen is somebody's gonna get a hell of a chewing out the next day. As we now know, when the Milburn made that move to port, the Evans finally responded, and the training that the Navy officers get in ship handling is when you're in a collision situation, if you don't know what to do, go starboard or to the right. Because if you're coming at each other and you both go right, you'll miss. So the Evans literally hung a hard right, not paying attention that these guys had already told him that we're coming port, hung a hard right, literally turned in a U-turn and came right back into the path of the Milburn, who impacted the Evans midships right between the stacks and cut it half completely. The front half of the ship fell over and sank within 2 minutes. And because they were just outside of the official Vietnam combat zone, the 74 lost crew are not on the Washington, D.C. Vietnam Memorial Wall. And we certainly hope that can change.